Despite the best efforts of the police and government, the hooligans had not gone away. Bizarrely, the solution to this scourge of society lay in the rave scene. Cass Pennant was a leader of the notorious West Ham hooligan firm, the ICF.
I remember a lot of the West Ham lads who'd come up to me on a Saturday at football, you know, what's happening to all our leaders? What's all this rave music? You know, are we gone soft? Are we fighting? Are we raving?
It was hilarious. I mean, so many of the football boys out there lightened up an incredible amount. And I think that that's probably got to be down to something, maybe a little pill here or there.
The loved up vibe generated by ecstasy was infectious, even for the most hardened hooligans. It wasn't long before the firms were organising parties themselves.
I was employing a security, but there's only two of us. I mean, they were so peaceful, these raves. But I'll never forget, the promoter come up and he said, "Cass, behave yourself." I said, "Why is that in?" He said, "You've got some guests that you ain't going to like." And I said, "Oh, who's that in?" He said, "Millwall." I said, "Yeah, that's not a problem. You know what I mean? I've seen everyone getting on. You know what I mean?" "No," he said, "you ain't going to like this. Yeah, there could be as many as 200. I said, "What?" I said, "You've employed two of us." He said, "Well, there's been a few other teams as well, Chelsea, Arsenal, all mixed in." He said, "Look, you've only got a problem because you're old guard, you're old school." He said, "You've got to get with it."
I absolutely played witness to seeing Millwall and Chelsea dancing together, hugging each other and talking to each other. And they would normally obviously be killing each other, you know, after invading a pitch somewhere.
I couldn't believe the whole night, yeah, was just a great buzz. You know, it's just one big loving.
It wasn't just football hooligans who were putting their differences aside.
That's the thing about the rave culture and ecstasy. It broke down barriers between people, because in Thatcher's Britain it was more like a divide and conquer kind of thing. And you're a Scouse and I hate you because you're from Liverpool and you're Cockney wanking and that. I think there was a revolution of the mind with people, and all those old attitudes were broke down.
There was a coming together of classes.